गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू. यस अबाइदा, आर यू एबल टू लिसन टू मी? माय वॉइस इज ऑडिबल टू यू? यस बिबिन, आर यू एबल टू लिसन टू मी? सो हाउ आर यू ऑल? एवरीथिंग इज फाइन? माय वॉइस इज ऑडिबल? You can increase, okay. Okay. So, thank you, Baida. So, did you know about this OBS software? How to play this OBS software, this one? Anyone of you knows about it or not? Let me just switch off the fan. Is there any noise in between? Please let me know if there is any noise in between. If there is any, you know, voice in between, please let me know. If there is noise, then I will switch off the fan. Please let me know. Yes, there is. Okay, wait. Then wait, I just switch it off. 1 minute. Yes. So I just now switch off the fan. I hope it is now it is audible to all of you. So now my voice is clear or not? Please let me know. My voice is clear or not? Yes, my voice is audible to all of you. Yes, it's clear now. Okay, good, good. So are you able to listen to my voice? Please let me know. Everything is fine now? I think it's fine now. I hoping so. Just ask me once again. Yes, okay, good, good. So you are able to get my voice. I think the signals are also good. Yes, everything is good now. So yes, now I welcome all of you in this afternoon session. And today we have to move further in our kingdom Animalia. So just waiting for 1 or 2 minutes more so that others will also join along with us. May I request all of you to kindly, you know, share the link with your friends also so that they will be joined with us. So please, if you are able to listen to me, then kindly ask, kindly share the link basically. Yes, everything is fine now. You are getting my voice? Yes, please reply. By your replies only I will be able to know whether everything is okay or not. So please let me know you are getting it. Voice is okay. There is one more noise. Let me correct it also. 1 minute, please. 1 minute. So yes, are you getting my voice? Please reply if you are able to listen to me, because I am unable to get your replies. Let me know whether you are getting me or not. Please let me know whether you are getting me or not, because I am not able to get your voice. So just let me know. Are you able to get my... Okay, everything is perfectly right. Okay, so shall we start now or not? You have any query, you want to ask something, then please let me know. Otherwise, we will start now. So please let me know if you have any query, you want to know anything. It's all right. Okay. So welcome Dixit. Welcome Abaida. We have Bibin along with us. We have Muhammad along with us. So I am welcoming all of you. And now we have to move further in our kingdom Animalia. So I am just going to share the slide. Just let me know whether you are getting it or not. Okay. So where is the slide? Here it is. So we are just doing the basic things, the taxonomy, the classification. What is taxonomy basically? What is, you can say, classification basically. Now we will move further to our presentation, because we are unable to do it yesterday. So sorry for it, but definitely we will do it today. And yes, I want to know one more thing, that tomorrow is Thursday. So is it possible that we will take our class at 2:30 p.m. Is it possible instead of 3 p.m. is it possible to take it at 2:30 p.m. that is half an hour before? If it is possible, please let me know. If it is possible, then please let me know. I think we are just... Yes, this is we have done already. Domains, archaea, bacteria, fungi, and then this has also we done. Yes, now we will start with classification. So yeah, okay, because for 3 days I have to come university. Like right now I am in the department, but tomorrow I am in my home. So that is why I am thinking that we will start sharply at 2:30 p.m. sharply, that without any type of delay we will start at 2:30 p.m. I will send you the link by 2:20, definitely by 2:20, and by 2:30 we will start the session. So that is why I am just asking, or a line from all of you whether you are free on that time or not. So we will just start at 2:30 p.m. sharply. So just do your lunch before it, everything, so that you are also free at that time. Okay, so are you able to get me? My voice is okay now, everything is fine. Please let me know once again. Please let me know. Okay, good. So now, like in the previous lecture, we have done basically taxonomy. That what is taxonomy, the pattern there in taxonomy, how we identify the species and how we name the species, or why we are pursuing with binomial nomenclature, why there is a need of a binomial nomenclature. And now today we will do classification of living things. We will do classification of living things. So in this we will study classification, like we have done taxonomy, but now we will start classification. So what is classification basically, or why we are needing this classification? So number first point is diversity. So biological diversity refers to the global variety of the species and ecosystems and the ecological processes of which they are part, covering three components. So diversity is basically the, you can say, yes. So diversity basically refers to the global variety of the species and ecosystems and the ecological processes of which they are part, covering three components. Which one? Genetic, species and ecosystem. So we have a diversity on the genetic level. Okay, we have the diversity, you can see variation at the genetic level, we have the diversity at the species level, and also we have the diversity at the ecosystemic level. So we have three types of diversity. So why there is a need of classification? Why we have to classify that these are the plants, these are animals, these are four-legged animals, these are, you know, flying animals or flying birds? Why there is a need of classification? Why there is a need of certain type of classification? So there are more than 2.5 million different living things on the earth. Millions more have not been yet discovered. So we have discovered only a small amount of the living things on the earth, but there are many things, there are many species which we have to discover yet. So life is diverse and needs to be organized. It is organized so that scientists all over the world have a universal method of classifying. So we need a universal method of classification. So organisms are placed into groups with their biological similarities. So like we are similar, we will be placed in a one group. Cats are similar, they will be placed in the cats group. Then dogs are four-legged animals, they will be placed in another group. So this is the placement basically on the basis of their biological similarities. So what is classification? Basically we have two terms in classification. The one is taxonomy. What is taxonomy? It is a science of naming and classifying organisms. The number one thing is to provide the name to the organism. You move to the forest, you just went to the forest and you see lots of, you know, or you can see another new thing there. So the number one thing which you have to do is to provide them the name, any name. So the first thing is to provide the name and then the classification of that particular organism. So we all know that Aristotle was a scientist who classified the, you know, he classified two groups. One is the plants and another is the animals. According to their structure, they classify two groups, plants and animals. So we all are aware of Aristotle, that he divides the into two groups. One is the plants and another is the animals. So now what happened? This we already discussed in the previous chapter, that some plants and animals could not be classified using this system. Why? Because when we are using the common name, when we are not, you know, recognizing them by their scientific name, when we are using the common name, what will happen? Like this is jellyfish. This is, the name of this organism is jellyfish. But basically it is not a fish, rather it is a cylindrate. So this is the confusion of the common name, that we are not able to get it, the original or the right thing. So jellyfish, from their common name, it indicates that it is a fish. But it is not a fish, rather it is a cylindrate. We will discuss it in deeply also. This we already done before. This maple tree, that there are three types of maple trees. So same common name for different species. The species are different, but the name is same for all the three. So the name is maple tree, but they are different species. Same name is given to different species. Then we have quagga, mountain lion and puma. So they are, yes, in the 70s, scientists realized that the common names were too confusing. They vary among languages and even regions. So yes, the names are too confusing. So then we have the Linnaeus. This scientist is there. The Linnaeus is the one who, you know, simplified naming and developed a system of binomial nomenclature. So this is the Linnaeus. He started the, you know, the naming of the organism on the basis of binomial nomenclature. So we have a classification consists of genus and the species. Genus is always starting with a capital letter and species is a lowercase. Like this is a genus. The first one is a genus and the last one is the species. Like Homo is the genus and sapiens is the species. So species is always in lower letters, and the scientific name, this scientific name like Homo sapiens, it should always be italics in nature. Like this is the scientific name of honeybees, Apis mellifera. So Apis is basically a genus and mellifera is the species. So in one genus we have many species like Apis mellifera, Apis indica, Apis serrana, Apis flori. So within one genus Apis we have four different species. Are you able to get it right now? Please let me know. Let me check it. Are you able to get it or not? Please let me know. I hope you are getting it. So please let me know, are you able to get it or not? Just reply, then I will just move forward to the slide. Please let me know. Please. Okay, good. So we have the binomial nomenclature in which we have the genus in the front and the back is the species. So genus, within one genus we have many species. Are you getting my point? Because genus comes before species. So within one genus we have many species. Okay, like within one order we have many families, the rhyme which you all know. So this is the thing, that within one genus like Apis, Apis is a scientific name of honeybee. So Apis is a genus, and Apis serrana, Apis indica, Apis mellifera, these all are the species. Getting my point? So just now I am moving further to the slides. So why there is a need of taxonomy? Why we are focusing on this taxonomy? Why? Because when we are, you know, giving the specific name to some organisms, what will happen? It works out a vivid picture of the existing diversity of life on earth. That is how these number of the organisms are already classified. So they give us a diversity of the life on earth, provides much of the information permitting a reconstruction of the history of life on earth, reveals numerous interesting evolutionary phenomena, supplies classifications which are of great explanatory value in biology as well as in plantology. So all these are the roles of taxonomy, that is why we are discussing it. Then we have biological classification system. What happened in biological classification system? All biological classification systems have three important characteristics. Number one, single universally accepted name to each organism. So there is only a single name for a single organism. If we write Apis mellifera, then this scientific name is only for one organism. Getting my point? You will not do that for two organisms, there will not be a single name. Like if you are, suppose we have Rahul here, we have Priya here, so Rahul and Priya are different. So their names are also different. So that is the thing, that only single universally accepted name to each organism. Each organism is giving the specific name. Organisms are placed into groups that have real biological meaning. So organisms are placed into groups, like either in the plants or in the animals, in the fungi or in the bacterial group. So they are just placed in the specific groups. Established rules for grouping organisms. So we have some rules according to which we are placing the organism, like we have group A, group B, group C. So we have some rules of placing the organisms. So this is a level of classification we already done: domain, kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species. So within genus we have many species. Within family we have many genus. Within order we have many families. Within class we have many orders. Within phylum we have many classes. And within a kingdom we have many phylums. Like in this lecture series we will discuss 9 phylums. Getting my point? So in kingdom Animalia we will discuss 9 phylums, 9 or 11 basically, not 9, we will discuss 11 phylums. So in those phylum we have to discuss their class, order, the family, the genus and the species. So we will start it from the kingdom, that is from Animalia. These are the trees that we have bacterial group, we have Arachibacteria and we have Eukarya. Eukarya are further divided into animals, plants and fungi. Very simple things basically. So there are some characteristics of the domains. Like in the bacteria, the cell wall, the cell structure is made up of peptidoglycan. Okay, and this example is Enterobacteria. In case of Eukarya, like in humans or eukaryotes basically, the cell wall is made up of cellulose. In case of fungi, if it's also Eukarya, the cell wall is made up of chitin. Sometimes these types of question also came in exam, that like in bacteria we have a peptidoglycan cell wall, in case of fungi we have a chitinous cell wall, in case of plenty, that means in case of plants, we have cellulose cell wall, and in case of animals, cell wall is absent. So in birds or earthworms you can say cell wall is basically absent. So this is all about the bacteria or eukarya. Like in eukarya, which we have to study, we have protista, which we have to study, then we have fungi, and then we have plantae, which is also known as plants, and the last is animalia. So we have to study this one only, that this animalia lacks cell walls, complex multicellular heterotrophs, zygotes develop through the several stages, they reproduce sexually. So these are all the characters in the kingdom Animalia. So what is basically classification? It is a grouping of living organisms according to similar characters. Grouping of organisms according to similar characters. If they are biological similar, then they are placed in a one group. Okay? So this is known as classification. Now what is taxonomy? Please let me know the difference between classification and taxonomy. What is the difference between classification and taxonomy? Let me know first. Yes, what is the difference between classification and taxonomy? Getting my voice? Please let me know what's the difference between classification and taxonomy. Please let me know. I am waiting for your replies. Please let me know the difference between, you know, classification and taxonomy. Please reply. Hello. Hi. कुछ नहीं फ्री ऑफ चार्ज का मैं फ्री ऑफ चार्ज का So yes, please let me know. If you are able to listen, please let me know the difference between taxonomy and classification. So we have taxonomy and classification. So what is the difference between both? Why are you not replying? Are you able to get me or not? Hello? Hello. I'm audible. Are you getting me? Hello. I think I'm not audible maybe. हेलो, यस यस। सो इफ आई एम ऑडिबल प्लीज लेट मी नो, एटलीस्ट से यस और नो। आई एम थिंकिंग आई एम अलोन हियर, सो प्लीज प्लीज लेट मी नो इफ यू आर हियर। ओके, सो आई एम आस्किंग यू वन क्वेश्चन, दैट वॉट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन टेक्सॉनमी एंड क्लासिफिकेशन। इन टेक्सॉनमी बेसिकली वी आर गिविंग द नेम, द नेमिंग ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिज्म, द नेमिंग एंड आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ द स्पीशीज। एंड इन क्लासिफिकेशन वॉट हैपन्स बेसिकली, देर इज अ ग्रुपिंग ऑफ ऑर्गेनिजम्स। लाइक आई एम 2 लैक्ड और 4 लैक्ड एनिमल्स आर प्लेस्ड इन समवेयर एल्स, और प्लांट्स आर प्लेस्ड इन अनदर ग्रुप। सो इट्स अ ग्रुपिंग ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म। So that is the difference between taxonomy and classification. So I just want the reply from all of you. Please let me know what is the difference between taxonomy and classification. Yes, please. You are here. If you are here, we have Shubham here, Divin here, Abaida here, Golden. Golden, how are you? So Golden here. So please let me know. And where is another? The Nature is here. There is one more student whose name is Nature. Where is he? Yes. Very good. Very good, Vibin. Very good. So I hope you are enjoying the session, or you are feeling bored. There are very interesting things we have to do in this kingdom Animalia. I hope you will enjoy it. So please reply, because I am unable to see your faces. By only these replies I am able to know whether you are getting me or not getting me. Okay. So just reply if you are present, then please reply. Yes, Natasha is replying. Yes, thank you Natasha, it's such a effort from you. Thank you a lot. So shall we continue now? Are you getting my points or not? Shall we continue? Okay, Vaibhav is saying he is enjoying the session. Okay, good. Thank you Vaibhav. So one more student is there, the Nature. Where is he? So if he is your friend, then please ask him that ma'am asking about you. Okay, so shall we start the session further? Yes, Abaida is also here. Okay, so now I will just move to another some important terms. Okay, so basically what classification is, it is a grouping. We just do the group A, group B, group C. It is a grouping of the living organisms according to the characteristics or according to their biological nature. So this is a thing like in the early eras or in the early time, we are grouping like that. Domestic animals, they are present in one group like donkey, dogs. Wild animals, they are placed in another group, like we have rhino, we have elephant, they are present in another group. We have creeping animals also, we have flying animals, and we have sea animals, in which we have fishes. So this is early, you know, early classification, in which we just do 5 groups, but this is not the right one. So a scientist called Aristotle, the very first scientist, grouped animals according to the way they moved. So according to the way this one is moving, this one is moving, this one is moving, according to the way they moved, they grouped the organisms. So the animal kingdom is basically divided into 2 groups. If you are able to see here, very early it is divided into 5 groups, but now the animal kingdom is divided into 2 groups. One is vertebrates and one is invertebrates. So we have vertebrates, which have a backbone. So So animals with a backbone, and we have invertebrates, animals without a backbone. So in this case, we don't have any type of backbone. So in which group we are basically? Humans are present in which group? Please answer. Humans are present in which group? Either we are vertebrates or we are invertebrates. We are vertebrates or we are invertebrates. Yes, yes, please reply all of you. We are vertebrates or we are invertebrates. Let me know. Okay, very good. We have Abaida, we have Baiban, and rest all of you, please reply. Yes, very good, Justin. Very good, Dixit. So we are vertebrates because we have a bone. So we have a specific bone, so that is why we come under the vertebrates. So we are basically the vertebrates. But in this lecture series, we will focus on invertebrates only. So we will discuss invertebrates in this lecture series, and in another lecture series, which is not decided yet, the date is not there till yet, we will discuss about the vertebrates. That means the classes or the organisms which are there in the vertebrates. But now for this session, we have invertebrates only. So invertebrates include mollusks like snails, these clams, starfish, sea urchin. These all comes under invertebrates. We will discuss it very thoroughly. Like insects, all insects, spiders, crabs, your insects, lobster, all these comes under the invertebrates, or you can say arthropods. So they are all are basically without bone insects. So they comes under invertebrates. And in vertebrates we have mammals in which human is there, we have birds, we have fishes, we have amphibians, and we have reptiles. So in vertebrates we have 5 classes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in case of vertebrates. In invertebrates we have 11 phylum basically. So we will discuss those phylums. Now you all know about mammals basically. That basically mammals are what? Number 1, they give birth to the babies, and parents take care of the baby until it can live alone. So in the mammals are those ones who have the capability or ability to give birth to the baby, and also they take care of the baby. Okay, and they also, you know, feed their babies with the milk. This is the important point of mammals, number 1. Number 2, lungs to breathe in oxygen, example whales. So they have specific lungs also, and they have hair or fur to keep them warm like polar bear. So this is the characters of the mammals, the important characters, not the whole characters, but the important characters, like that they have hair or fur, lungs are there, they give birth to the babies, all it comes under the mammals. Like this is a mammal, and they have the young ones also, they also feed, they have lungs also. This is a polar bear, they also come under the your mammals. They have the fur for the isolation or the heat isolation. Then what are the characters, the main characters in the birds? First of all, the birds are 2 legs only. They have 2 legs only, and their 4 legs are modified into wings. So they have 2 legs only and wings, and they have feathers also. We all know about it. And what is the function of these wings? These wings help them to fly. But some cases are there, like penguins are there, which have the wings but they can't fly. Then these birds also lay eggs, like we all know that hen is there, or many other birds. So they lay eggs, and they breathe oxygen from the air with the help of lungs. So this is birds. This is a penguin which is unable to fly. Then we have reptiles. You all know about reptiles. In reptiles basically we have snakes and we have lizards. So what's their characteristic? Yes, skin is covered with scales, thin flat plates to protect the animals. So the skin of the snakes, if you are able to see, is covered with the scales, and they have dry skin. Why they have the dry skin basically? And they some lay eggs and some give birth. So they are ovoviviparous. They are oviparous, that is they are laying eggs, and they are viviparous also, that is they are giving birth to the young ones. So they are ovoviviparous. And what about the lungs? Reptiles that spend lots of time in water go to the surface to breathe oxygen. So they have the lungs also. So what are the characteristics they have? They have dry skin, number one. Their body has scales all over, number two. They have lungs, number three. And number four, they are ovoviviparous. So they are basically ovoviviparous in nature. So this is the crocodiles, and they have the scales. If you are able to see here, they have the scales like here all over the body. So scale is present all over the body. So this is again the tortoise is there, the chameleon is there. They all have the scales for the protection purposes. And they have the eggs also. Eggs have tough leathery shells. So this is the eggs. Then we have fish. This is the fish. What are the characteristics of fish? Number one, instead of lungs, they have gills for respiration. So if they want to do respiration in water, so lungs will not be there. And what's the function of lungs in the water? So they have the gills only. And they live their whole life in the water. So fishes have the ability to live their whole life under water. Their skin is covered with scales. The scales are there. Most lay eggs, some give birth. So fishes also lay eggs, but some give birth also. Then the another one is amphibians. The another class is amphibians. They lay eggs in water. The common example is frogs. So they lay eggs in water. They have the moist skin. If you have seen frog somewhere, like this frog or this frog, they have very moist skin. Young live in water and adult live on land. This is all we know, that the young larvae or the young ones of the frog, they live in the water, but when they become adult, they move out outside and they live on the land basically. So these are the amphibians we have. So we have salamander, we have toads, we have frog, all these come under amphibians. So are you able to get it till now? I hope you are able to get it. It's a very simple classification basically. Then after it we have biological classification. We already done it, that how we just group the organisms. So taxonomy is basically what? Is a science of classifying organisms, or it's a science of giving names and identification to the organisms. Aristotle we already discussed. This is we also discussed, that deer King Philip came over for good soup, or came over for gooseberry soup. So it's the rhyme basically. We have done the seven levels of classification, or six kingdoms of classification. We have done seven levels of classification, like kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species, already discussed. I will not discuss it again. And then we have done what is binomial, the binomial nomenclature, in which we are giving the name of the genus and the species. Yes, so taxonomy is the science of naming and classifying things, or you can say identifying the things. Linnaeus is the one who is known as father of taxonomy. So this is a scientist who is known as Linnaeus. He is known as the father of taxonomy because he is the one who introduced binomial nomenclature, or how we will place the species in kingdom, phylum, class, order, family and genus. So how we are able to place the organism within this classification system. So this is a classification of humans. We belong to the kingdom Animalia. Phylum is Chordata. Class is Mammalia, because we have the ability to give birth to a young one and to feed them also. Order Primates. Family Hominidae. Genus is Homo, and species is Sapiens. So we are Homo sapiens basically. Now this is Devil Cat. This is Ghost Cat. Mountain Lion. Screaming Cat. Puma. Florida panther, jaguar. So there are at least 50 common names for animals shown. Common names vary according to the reasons. So according to the reasons, they have the different common names. But we have the authentic or original binomial nomenclature in which we are, you know, identifying organism by using a combination of genus and species. So this is binomial nomenclature, and we have kingdom system here. I will show you. Yes. So from Linnaeus to Smith, we have, like, Linnaeus introduced two kingdoms only, plants and animals. This is the kingdoms provided by Linnaeus. Then in 1866, Haeckel is a scientist who provides three kingdoms, Protista, Plantae and Animalium. Then again we have two, you can say, kingdoms, basically prokaryotes and eukaryotes. So and we move on, up to 2004, we have six kingdoms. We have bacteria, we have protozoa, chromista, fungi, plantae and animalia. But our main focus is on animalia only. So we will do animalia. So we have plants, plantae, animalia, fungi, protista, archaebacteria and eubacteria. But we will study animalia only. So this is the character of the another domains, basically the character of protista, in which we have amoeba, paramecium, and then we have these algae which are present, like red algae, brown algae, green algae. Then we have kingdom fungi, in which we have mushrooms. So if you are able to see here, we have mushrooms which belongs to the kingdom fungi. So they are the mushrooms. And then kingdom plantae, in which we have the plants. So in the kingdom plantae we have plants. This is the plant or the flower. But our main focus is on the, these all comes under plants. All this comes under the plants. The pinus tree, they all are plants. The pinus tree, these are needle shaped leaves, they all comes under the plants. But our main focus is on, these all are plants. But our main focus is on kingdom Animalia. So this is our main focus. We have to study animal kingdom basically. Okay. Are you getting it? So we have two types, vertebrates and invertebrates. We will study invertebrates. That's the animal without backbones. So in invertebrates, this one which we have to study, we have many phylums like echinoderms, sponges, cnidarians, worms, mollusca and arthropoda. We will discuss all these organisms or all these phylum in detail. So first phylum which we have to study today is phylum Porifera. But up to it, is it clear to all of you? Let me know. Then I will start the phylum. Up to it, is it clear to all of you? Please let me know. Then I will start the first phylum, the very first phylum, which is phylum Porifera. Please let me know. Yes, good, good. It's clear to you. Good. So is it clear to all of you? Please let me know. So shall we continue with our first phylum, which is phylum Porifera? Shall we continue with the first phylum? So please reply. So we have to study our first phylum, which is phylum Porifera. So are you able to get it or not? Everything is clear to all of you? Please let me know, everything is clear? Yes. Yes, okay. Thank you, Balvin. Thank you. Thank you, Natasha. So now we will move with our first phylum, which is phylum Porifera. And they are also known as sponges. So why they are known as sponges or Porifera? Let us see. So sponges, these all are the sponges which are found very deep in the oceans. They are the simplest form of animal. Sponges are very sessile animals. What do you mean by sessile? That is, they are very delicate basically, and they spend their lives attached on the rocks. So generally they spend their whole life by attaching on the rocks which are present in the deep ocean. So this is basically sponges. Then we have another phylum, which is Cnidaria, in which we have jellyfishes. We will discuss this phylum also. So this is the organisms which are there in the phylum Cnidaria. We have corals here in Cnidaria, and if you are able to see, this person is in the deep ocean and he is searching for all these the wonderful creatures which we have, but they are just under the water. So they are just searching for these wonderful creatures which are present under the water, basically very deep in the water. So they belong to the phylum Cnidaria. And in the phylum Cnidaria we have Hydra, we will discuss. We have sea anemones. So you must see these fishes in the movies also. So these things are they are sea anemones, and they all are living ones. So we have sea anemones. Now we have another phylum, which is Platyhelminthes. Here is S. So we have Platyhelminthes, which are basically the worms which are present in the intestine of human or in the intestine of some another host. So this is phylum Platyhelminthes. Then we have round worms. These worms are also present inside the humans. If you are able to see, this is the eye of a person, and the person's eye has a worm in between it. Are you able to get it? So these are the worms which are present inside the intestine or in the brain or in the lungs or in the eyes of the human. So they are very dangerous worms. They are very parasitic in nature. So this is the your round worms which is present in the eye. So these are the worms. Then we have Annelida phylum, in which we have earthworm to study. So earthworm belongs to the phylum Annelida. Then we have phylum Mollusca, in which we have gastropods or cephalopods, basically those organisms which are found under water. They are in gastropods. So these are known as shanks, but I don't know how to know or what is English name. So you must see all of these things in the deep ocean when you go for some type of beach or somewhere. So you must see all these things. So all these things basically they belong to the phylum Mollusca. So we will study, yes, Cypia. I don't know what is the English name. Please let me know if it's English or the name on your side. What is the local pronunciation of these things? You must have seen all these things in the beaches also. Please let me know their name. I'm not remembering the local pronunciation of these bivalves. Then we have cephalopods, in which we have octopus. It also belongs to the phylum Mollusca. Then we have another phylum. The last phylum which we have to study is phylum Echinodermata, in which we will study starfish. We have another phylum which is Arthropoda, in which we will study all the insects, either the butterfly, the grasshoppers, the bugs, ants are there, dragonfly is there, honeybee is there, mosquito is there, and the common fly is also there. So they belong to the phylum Arthropoda. And of course in phylum Arthropoda we have spiders, we have scorpions, we have crabs. They also belong to the phylum Arthropoda. And yes, these prawns are also there in the phylum. Prawns and crabs are also there in the phylum Arthropoda. And in the Arthropoda we also have centipedes and millipedes. So these are the julies, or you can say centipedes or millipedes. And in the phylum Chordata we have frogs, reptiles, birds, fishes and mammals. So this is the thing basically which we have to study. So these are the fishes basically. These are the sharks which are there in water. But we will not study these in detail right now. These all are the things. The birds, the mammals, the carnivores, the Chiroptera, the bats, which are the main cause of the COVID-19. You all know about it. The primates, the gorilla and this beautiful creature. I don't know the name of it. Maybe lemur. So this is the thing which is there in the, which we have to study basically. Yes, I think that's all for, I think that's all in this PPT. Yes. So this is all the thing which is there in the, we have one more thing which is the species definition. I will tell it to you when we will start the phylum, then I will tell it to you. Yes, yes. Yeah, they are known as shells. But I am not remembering their local name. They must have some local name like Sippy or something like that. So I am not able to get their local names. So yes, we will have to study, or we will start basically with our first phylum, which is phylum Porifera. So tomorrow we will meet at 2:30 p.m. with phylum Porifera. A very brief, today we have just seen the organisms which are there in different phylums, but from tomorrow onwards we will definitely, or we will thoroughly or deeply study each and every phylum. So we will start with the phylum Porifera, which is number 1. So are you able to get it everything today? I have not shown you any video today. I want to, but I think we will start it tomorrow with phylum Porifera. So are you able to get it or not? Please let me know. Are you able to get it or not? Please let me know. Please, please, it will be so nice of you if you are able to reply. Please reply if possible. So please reply if you are able to listen to me. So please let me know whether you are getting it or not. So we have Ankita. Ankita, how are you? Yes, Natasha. Okay. So it's a very simple. We have so many, you know, beautiful creatures along with us. We have so much of diversity, either in the ocean or even in the land. But we are unable to see the diversity which we have. So it's my request to all. Yes, it's my request to all of you to be with nature. So to be with the nature basically. So that's my request to all of you to be with nature, to see something extra which is just there, but we are not noticing those things. So please, please enjoy the nature basically. Enjoy every moment of your life. When you are seeing anything, just enjoy everything, because there is so much beauty which is present in the earth, but we are unable to see it. Okay, so with all these positive words, I think I will conclude today's session. Yes, please, any one of you, share your this email ID on the WhatsApp group. Then I will share this PPT with all of you, or I will share with anyone. I will mail any one of you, and then the student will forward it in the group. So is it clear? Yes, yes, yes. You will get the PPT. No issues regarding it. I just request you to send me your email, because I am unable to attach this file on my mobile because the PPT is there in the laptop. So just share your email, I will send it to one or two, then you will have to send it in a group. Okay, are you getting me or not? Yes, yes, thank you Bhavin if you are getting it. So that's all for today's session. Please share your email ID with me. I will share the PPT and the presentation with all of you. So that's all from my side. Okay. Yes. So we will meet tomorrow sharply at 2:30 PM. So be ready for the tomorrow timings. And also I request you to please like and share my YouTube channel and subscribe to it, because some of you have not subscribed it yet. So it's my request only to please subscribe my channel and support me. So thank you for my side. We will meet tomorrow. Bye bye. Take care. Bye bye to all of you. Yes, yes. Bye bye. Bye bye to all.